What's your name?
Rahul.
Sit down.
Rahul, it's actually so simple that you might be missing it. You're asking, yes, I understand that it is important to know myself, that the world can be known only if I first understand the knower, and the knower is me. But you're asking for a method, a path. You're saying, how to know myself? All right, knowing myself is important, but how to know myself? The how is where you are stuck, right? The how is so obvious that you are missing it. What do you mean by myself? What do you mean by myself? When you say myself, you mean this that you are doing all the time. All this is the self. The actions that you are doing physically. You just rose and asked a question. Who did this? The self. And now you might be thinking. And who is the thinker? Who is the thinker? The self. Everything that is happening or seems to be happening is the work of the self. So how to know the self? Come on. How to know the self? Watch what is happening. Just watch what is happening. What is happening? You are asking. You are listening. You are walking. You are occupying a particular seat. You are thinking. And the thoughts are of 1,000 colors. This is the self. Observe this and you have known the self. There is no other method. And this is not a method at all. Because it is so simple that it can't even be called a method. What we are actually saying is, just be a little conscious. Just keep your eyes open. If you go somewhere routinely and you find that the moment you reach that place, you become a little scared. See that this is happening. All right. The moment I reach this place, my heart starts beating a little faster. You meet a particular person, and this has been happening for a long while. You meet a particular person and you find that you cannot say what you want to say. Observe that this is happening. Yeah? Observation of the self and the observation of the world will go hand in hand. The more clearly you can look at yourself, the more is the clarity that you get in looking at the world. It's a very obvious thing that somebody who does not understand himself can make no sense of the world either. Is that not true? I do not know what is here, how can I know what is there? But our entire education has been telling us, look there and look there. Never look here. But how can you know what is there if you do not know what is here? Because here is the one who looks. How can you ever know that without knowing this? But your entire education has been about knowing that. History, geography, sciences, technology. At no point have you been told that the most important thing is to look here. That is something that we have not been really told. And that's where mankind is stuck. We are not looking intelligently at how the mind functions. We are obsessed with collecting knowledge. And we are paying no attention to the collector of the knowledge. The knower is unknown, and it's a very amusing situation. The knower is unknown. Now, what can be known if the knower is unknown? Yes, and knowing the knower is so easy. Keep your eyes open, just see what's going on in your own universe, and it will be apparent. All right?